Hello and assalamu alaikum. My name is Muhammad Ali and today we are going to be learning about event, and let's get started. So event is what? Event is something that when it happens, do something. Okay, it's like if this happens, do something. It's similar, but it's when, not if. Okay, so let's get a simple example. Well, first of all, I'd like to say that there are three types of event handlers, or to be more specific, there are three places in which you can use event handlers, and all these places have their own event handlers and which are different from others. Okay, we are going to be covering two of them. The third one is not related because we haven't covered that tutorial yet or that subject yet. So let's see. The first event handler is this workbook or workbook events. Workbook events are something that when something happens in the workbook book triggered, a code will be triggered which we produce. Okay, simply we're gonna go workbook, gonna click on this workbook, and it says these are the events or event handler. Okay, event handlers or events. So basically what it says is whenever workbook is opened, do something. Okay, let's say I'm going to say message box. That would be message box. Welcome. I'm going to say just that. I'm going to save this. Okay. I'm going to just close it. And just here is it. I'm going to just open it again. Okay. Now it says welcome. When we opened it, it said welcome. That's all. Whenever something happens in the worksheet, it's going to trigger that code. So for this, when our workbook is opened, when our workbook opens, it's going to trigger this code. Okay, let's look at some other codes. A simple one, for example, we're going to say sheet active. Okay, we're going to say message box. Sheet. Okay, sheet dot name. Oh, sorry. Sheet. Okay, let's get a first sheet for now because I need to put and sh dot name. That would have worked. Okay, so I'm gonna say sheet 3 is gonna say you went to sheet 3. Sheet 4. Oh, sheet 4. Oh, I messed up. Okay, I didn't need to use this. I just need to say sh dot name, so it's gonna bring up that sheet name. So let's check it out. Okay, sheet 3, sheet 2, and whatever. So it's saying whenever a sheet is activated, means whenever I go to some sheet, it's gonna trigger this code. And in this code, it says like, tell me the sheet name. You can say, for example, whenever I go to some sheet, change its range to range 1, means cell 1. Right, even dot call dot interior dot color dot application dot color equals RGB. Black. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna go in here. It's converted black. It's black. Well, now you understand, I think. Okay, you can check out these codes in here. There are a lot of them. For example, there is change whenever something is changed in on your worksheet. For example, whenever a sheet is deactivated, whenever sheet is deactivated, you want to say that tell me the sheet. You want to say message box. You have deactivated a sheet. For example, let's say we are in here. We're gonna go in here. It's gonna say you have deactivated a sheet. You have deactivated a sheet. Okay. Okay. I think that would be clear to you. Okay. The second type of event is not a type of event. I think I'm referring it wrongly because it's not a type. It's where it exists. Number one, it exists in workbooks. So there are workbook event handlers, there are sheet event handlers, and thirdly, there are other event and handlers. Okay, let me tell you what are those. You might think I don't know. They are user form event handlers. For example, you go to user form, double click in here. That is the event handler. On click event handler, on add error, on initialize, and stuff like that. Okay, we won't be covering this. Okay, on the sheet, I'm gonna go to sheet and I'm gonna say workbook. Okay, so it says whenever something is changed, so selection is changed. Let's say message box, you have changed. Okay, so let's say 100, 200. Okay, I think that code is running behind. Oh, let me check it out. Selection.change. Okay, I say selection change. That would make a difference. Because a lot of times something might work and other thing might not work. I'm gonna say like 100 again. What the hell? It's not working! What the hell is it not working? Basically, the reason would be that this is simply the sheet one. Yeah, because I'm referring these two things to sheet one. If I go back to sheet one, the previous code of mine that was in workbook is gonna run. Okay, I'm gonna say like you have changed something, because even if I select something, it's gonna say you have changed. Okay, so it's gonna say selection change. For example, I selected from this to this, it's gonna say you have changed something. But if I like change 100 to something, it's gonna again say you have changed something, but two times. Let's say what? Okay, you change your position. Okay, so I'm gonna say, come in here, I'm gonna say from here, you have changed your position. I didn't change anything in it. So if I change this to 200, it's gonna say you have changed. You didn't change your position, you have changed. And similarly, we have also, you have also changed your position. Well, that should be obvious, because when I clicked on enter, I have changed my position. Okay, well, there are others, a lot of, for example, deactivate, follow hyperlinks, and before, delete, or I would say like a lot of them. You can check this out. Okay guys, thank you very much. That was whole tutorial, and if you have any question regarding this tutorial or other, make sure to put it in the comment box below. Thank you.